Good evening and welcome to Village of Romeoville's workshop meeting this Wednesday, April 17th, 2013 at 6:01 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmeyer.
Here.
Trustee Chavez.
Here.
Trustee Clancy. Trustee Richards.
Here.
Trustee McClevitt.
Here.
Trustee Griffin.
Here.
Mayor Noak.
Here.
We have a quorum.
Very good. Trustee Palmeyer, will you lead us in the pledge?
Yes, thank you. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Before we begin our program this evening, I'd like to take a moment of silence for those lost and injured, and remembering those who were injured as well in Boston. So if you'll join me in a moment of silence, please. Thank you. First on the agenda this evening, we have the swearing in of four fire lieutenants and one firefighter paramedic. Big day for the fire department. Look at all you guys. Looking good up there.
See you blue.
Thank you, Your Honor. As you already mentioned, this is a very exciting day for us. Today represents the culmination of probably about a 5 or 6 year journey to get to this point, and through the support of the board, village staff, and we really tried the Fire and Police Commission, since it's a whole new process, it's something new for them, and we challenged them. So we're here tonight and we're very happy. First of all, I'd like to introduce the four lieutenants, to tell you a little bit about them. The first gentleman is Chad Ziller. He's originally from Kankakee. He began his fire service career while in high school in 2000 as a cadet for the Limestone Fire Protection District. While at Limestone, he obtained his EMT certification and his paramedic certification, as well as his firefighter certification. He left Limestone with the rank of engineer in 2005. Started his career with the Romeoville Fire Department in 2004 as a part-time member of the department. Became full-time in 2005. While with us, he's obtained further certifications in hazmat, technical rescue, and fire officer training. He's also an active staff instructor for the Romeoville Fire Academy, and he also does a lot with our fitness and training division. He's also currently the president of the Romeoville Professional Firefighters Local 4237. He's moved to Romeoville, lives in Romeoville, moved here in 2005, where he resides with his wife, Megan, and they have two sons, age 3 and 3 months. I think you heard one of his sons earlier. The next gentleman is Edward Delaurier, EJ. When I use Edward Delaurier, no one on the department even knows who I'm talking about. EJ started the fire service in 2000 with the Evergreen Park Fire Department, where he received his paramedic training. He worked as a contract paramedic with the North Palos Fire Protection District until 2007, when he was hired by us. He moved to Sandwich in 2006 with his wife Tammy and her daughter Cassidy. Tammy and EJ have been married since 2009. Since starting with the fire department here, he's attended numerous classes through our fire academy, including technical rescue, hazmat, and advanced firefighting. He's attained certifications in all these areas. He became our hazmat coordinator in 2011. He also assists with support services within the department, which includes vehicle maintenance and small tools. The next gentleman I'd like to introduce is Lieutenant Mike Spradow. He started his fire service career by attending EMT school at the College of DuPage. He continued his career advancement through paramedic training at the Southern Fox Valley EMS system. He joined the Romeoville Fire Department in February 2008 and became a full-time member in 2010. During his career, he's had the opportunity to participate in our honor guard. He's been very active in our honor guard, and 2 years ago, he was inducted into the AFFI Honor Guard, which is the union's honor guard. In the last year, he joined our Mavis Division CRT team, and he also serves as our public education officer. He also instructs with the Romeoville Fire Academy. The last gentleman, our last promotion, is Lieutenant Art Zamala. Art's been a member of the Romeoville Fire Department for the past 13 years. He started with us in 2000 as a part-time member and was hired full-time in 2005. He attended EMT school at the College of DuPage, paramedic school at Edward Hospital in Naperville and obtained a bachelor's degree at Southern Illinois University. He served in the capacities of acting officer. He's also a member of our Foreign Fire Insurance Board, numerous department committees, fire, and as well as a member of the fire investigation team. He's married to Marissa, has two daughters, Julia and Olivia, and a soon-to-be son. And if I could call those four gentlemen forward so we can swear you in. Go ahead. Probably right to the main.
You raise right hand and repeat after me. I, and state your name individually, do solemnly swear that I will perform the duties of a fire lieutenant to the best of my ability, that I take this obligation freely without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion, that I will faithfully discharge the duties I am about to enter. And I do further swear that I am not affiliated with any group that advocates the overthrow of the government of the United States of America and the Constitution of the State of Illinois. Congratulations.
And right now we're handing them out a certificate from the Fire and Police Commission that indicates their promotion. Commissioner Herbst was planning on being here tonight. He called me this afternoon. Unfortunately, he's on his way to London right now, so he couldn't be here. I also failed to mention, besides being exciting for Lieutenant Spradow, his promotion, he's also expecting, so our family continues to grow. He's not expecting, his wife is. It's a medical miracle. Besides the promotions, another very exciting time for us is when we welcome new members to our family, and tonight we have an opportunity to recognize a new member. He is firefighter paramedic John Loesch. While he doesn't look old enough, I can promise you he is. He's 22 years old right now. He's from Rolling Meadows, and he currently lives in Rolling Meadows. He's always aspired to have a career in firefighting. Upon finishing high school, he went and received his EMT license, enrolled in paramedic school through the Northwest Community Hospital's EMS system, and was given an opportunity through sponsorship by the Fox River Countryside Fire District to attend the Elgin Community College. Okay.
Very good.
I'll get through this. While at the Fox River Countryside Fire District, he was given an opportunity to become one of their paid-on-call members, and then shortly thereafter became a full-time member of that department. Went through our process, was successful, and since then we've hired him. And we're very excited. He's been a great addition to the department, and we look forward to a great career with him. So I'd like to introduce firefighter paramedic John Loesch.
Raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, and state your name.
I, John Loesch.
Do solemnly swear that I will perform the duties of a firefighter paramedic to the best of my ability, that I take this obligation freely without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion, that I will faithfully discharge the duties I am about to enter. And I do further swear that I am not affiliated with any group that advocates the overthrow of the government of the United States of America And the Constitution of the State of Illinois. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, before they all take off, I'd like to personally say, you know, I've had the opportunity, especially of our new four lieutenants, to know each one of them for a few years now and work with each and every one of them. And not only are they amazing assets to our community, they're amazing people, and they have amazing families. And I want each and every one of them to know that there's no doubt in my mind that they all have my faith and absolute respect, and I know they will continue to do just an amazing job for us. And to our newest member of the department, John, don't be too scared, but clearly you need to move in and help increase the population of the village as well. I'm sure they did not tell you that ahead of time, but everybody else has got a leg up on you. So, but welcome to the family. As you can tell, it's a family, and we couldn't be more excited to have you join it. So, but these guys before you, they're around you, they're excellent, and I'm sure you will be as well. So thank you all. Now, as they all get to meet our very special guest, you know, you guys might want to hang out for this one. We're going to diverge from our program a little bit this evening and recognize our special guest that just joined us. And today we have a very special occasion. Anna Budzinski, who has joined us here, is turning 100 years old, or turned 100 years old on April 7th. And we're here to celebrate her birthday. And we believe you are the longest Romeoville resident currently with us. And that's a very special occasion. And if we find one that's been here longer, I think we're all going to be surprised. Anna's family's actually got some connections to... Anna's family actually has a special connection to the village. Her brother was Commissioner of Public Works in the 50s under Mayor Murphy. So if you could all join me in giving a rousing applause to Anna on her 100th birthday. What's a birthday without a cake? So we got you a cake.
Oh my goodness.
And we got you some flowers too. But it really is. Well, I'm glad you could join us and that you're healthy today. Come on, one more round of applause for Anna. Everybody get out of here. We'll take a moment. It's kind of fun to have some of our newest residents and our longest resident all in the same room. Happy birthday, Anna. Well, it truly is very special to have a resident that's been with us all 100 years of her life. That is something very, very special. So glad she could come out and join us today. Now that we got all really exciting stuff out of the way, back to the regular scheduled program here. First of all, we have Ordinance 131043, Ordinance adopting the annual operating budget for fiscal year 2013-2014 for the village of Romeoville, Will County, Illinois. Kirk Openchowski, please.
Good evening, Mayor and Board. Tonight, we are presenting the ordinance to implement our budget for fiscal year 13-14, which begins as May 1st. The budget was presented to the mayor and board at one goals and objective workshop and one budget presentation workshop, both which were open to the public. The workshops were held December 12th, 2012 and April 11th, 2013. There will also be a public hearing tonight as part of the regular meeting regarding the budget. The preliminary budget is on file with the clerk's office and at the White Oaks Library District. And after the budget is passed, we'll also get the final budget over to the clerk's office and the library as well. In conjunction with the meeting tonight, the preliminary budget was also published in the paper with a high-level summary. The total budget is $114,449,050, a 25%, $23 million increase over last year's budget of $91.4 million. The increase is due in part to the construction of the proposed athletic and event center and other downtown improvements totaling over $18 million. The corporate fund budget is $46,019,900, a 7%, $3.2 million increase over last year's budget of $42,864,405. The water and sewer fund budget is $21,055,100, a 6%, $1.3 million decrease over last year's budget of $22,382,800. Bond and TIF construction fund budgets are $28,208,000, a 147%, $16,783,500 increase over last year's budget of $11,424,500. That budget includes the athletic and event center that I previously spoke. The operating expenditures budget, which is the day-to-day budget to operate the village, which excludes our pension funds, bond construction funds, interfund transfers, and fund balance reserve projects, is $65,428,600, which is an 8%, $4.7 million increase over last year's budget of $67,45,005. Our three largest categories of expenditures are capital projects of $33,986,000, which is 30% of the budget, personnel expenditures, which are $29,393,800, which is 26% of the budget, and contractual services of $20,157,350, which is 17% of the budget.
Very good. All right. Just to summarize a little bit of what Mr. Opachowski said, the increase of the overall budget is primarily due to new construction, which is one-time projects. That's what that's about. The actual operating budget is only a 7% increase. Primarily that is due to healthcare costs, other mandatory increases that are put upon every local government. That's something that everybody's facing, especially with the changes in the federal healthcare legislation being a large chunk of that increase. The actual water and sewer budget is actually going down this year. Some of the other things that Kirk didn't touch upon, just so everybody at home knows, within that budget, some of the highlights that we'd really like to everybody understand, so they understand the overall budget, there is no additional full-time staff. There is a tree replacement program added this year, something that I know a lot of residents were asking about. So that has been included for this year. One of the projects the capital projects that will be included in this year will be an expansion of the village hall and athletic parking lot. That's kind of the shared parking lot between the two sites. that'll allow for additional parking for special events, something that we had planned eventually for the project, so that we're able to implement that. So there's a couple of the newer things in addition to the capital that we've already discussed at board meetings, which primarily revolve around TIF projects in the downtown, which is the vast majority of all of that additional funds that are temporary for the project only in the one, you know, for the 1 or 2 years. Also, some of the other major highlights so that everybody does understand, the village portion of your total tax bill will actually, as a percentage, will go down again this year. 3 years ago, we were at 15%. Last year, we were 14%. This year, we will only, on average, be 13% of your total property tax bill. So the village, as a proportion of your total property tax bill, will actually go down. There are no new taxes or fees in this program that are already weren't already in place. There will actually be, on average, the residential property taxes will decrease in this budget by an average of $2 throughout the village. So the village portion of the property taxes has actually gone down in percentage, and there will actually be a decrease in the actual amount on average that residents pay, and there is variation. We have three townships, and if you've done an addition on your home, there are going to be variations in that, but on average, the average property tax will go down this year about $2. So it is going down again this year. It went down last year, went down the year before that. So again, the village portion, the actual amount you pay is going down, and as a percentage of the total tax bill, property tax bill, has actually decreased as the percentage for the other taxing bodies has increased. Also, there will be another rebate program again this year. Residents will once again receive a rebate in October on their water bills. And trying to see if there's anything else. And several of our other ongoing projects, but those are some of the newer additions to the highlights for this coming year. Also, we will be looking at rehabilitation of Fire Station 1 or construction of the new fire station, which is something we've been talking about now for several years that's been in our long-term plans, which is also a part of this year's budget. Street resurfacing, there'll be quite a bit of street resurfacing. One of the large highlights on street resurfacing is Taylor Road, which we received federal grants for, and a portion of that's being paid off of motor fuel taxes, but we received it'll be a total of a $2.6 million project. Vast majority of that is off of us receiving federal grants for. And then also we will be installing the Route 53 signal at in front of Romeoville High School and Material Service Road, which we also received a federal grant for. So some of the additional highlights, projects that we had put in place and we received additional funding for. So question or comments from the board? Trustee McLevitz, I had a feeling you were going to.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I think as a resident, what is important to me is how is that budget going to impact me with my taxes? And as the mayor indicated, hopefully most everybody will see a decrease in taxes. So whether it's a decrease of $2 or even flat, I think one of the things that's important to note is that the consumer price index, which is basically cost of living, has gone up the last couple of years 3.1% and 1.5%. Yet our taxes aren't going up 3.1% and 1.5%. We're either staying level or decreasing. So I think that's very important to point out. The other thing, obviously, the large increase in capital, you jump back from that saying, wow, that seems like a lot. But questions that were asked during the budget meetings is whether or not we have dedicated fund source for that, and we do. And so those are the things that when I went through the budget that were important to me, that we do have a dedicated fund source for those capital projects, which alleviates any fears there. And the fact that I think the staff is doing an excellent job keeping our costs in line, even though there's a lot of cost of living going up, as you said, insurance being one of the large ones that's really impacting everybody. So I think it's a very conservative budget, even though there's a lot of growth within it as far as being able to address a lot of the various services that we continue to provide for the residents.
Very good. Anyone other questions? Trustee Griffin?
Yeah, thank you, Mayor. I had the opportunity to work at a conference for developers, and
consistently one of the things that they look for before moving a business to a community is whether or not the community is investing in their infrastructure. And they look upon that as a real key indicator of how forward-looking the village is and as to whether or not they, in fact, want to invest the money in their own community before asking a business to come and invest their money. And our town has stood out in our willingness and our foresight in continuing to invest in infrastructure. And I think that's one of the reasons that we have been so successful in attracting other businesses.
Very good. Trustee Richards.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. All very good comments. And a lot of these discussions were held at the public budget meeting. Want to make sure everyone's aware of a couple of things. There is a decrease in water and sewer. We're not ignoring roads, as the mayor mentioned. We're doing quite a bit in road repair, about $1.5 million just in-house street resurfacing. In addition to the Taylor Road project, we are continuing with our crack sealing program to try and extend the lives of our roads. I mean, roads are one thing we talk about here all winter long and what great shape they're in. It also helps to be able to have a good road to plow in the winter. The fact that we keep them in good workable condition makes a big difference. I think residents are proud of that as well. Goes back to when a business wants to come into town, they don't want to see crumbling roads. We are still continuing the inflow and infiltration project so we can continue to extend the lives of our sewer systems and the crack sealing program as well. So I just don't want people to think we're starting to ignore those things, and that's where you see a decrease there.
Very good. Trustee Chavez.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. Yeah, I agree. Everything that's being said is it's all positive stuff, and just want residents to understand it. A budget is a living document, something that we set forth as a team, and we try to follow that, decrease it, increase it. It's all fluctual. It's a living document. One of the nice things also that we have in this budget that I think needs to be mentioned to the residents is this also includes new vehicles for the police department. It includes new vehicles for our public works to keep our streets and our systems and our sewers in great functioning order. You know, as mentioned about infrastructure, I can't stress that enough. That's so important. I think Dan Bromberg and his crew is doing a great job. As a matter of fact, just right before, a couple weeks ago, they were blowing out sewers or something like that over in Lakewood Estates, and residents called and said, hey, what's going on? And you know, it's all about maintaining our infrastructure, and I can't agree. I believe we're getting a new vacuum truck, which is, you know, that's stuff that you really don't see much. Our residents, you don't see driving down the street every day like a police car, but it's something that's critical to our infrastructure and the long-term viability, as mentioned, to bring in new businesses. And the capital expenditures we have going here are to reinvest in our municipality on what people call the east side, what people call the downtown, what I call home, because I grew up on that side. I still live on that side. And it's to reinvest, to regenerate that area. So we're spending money to try to improve things in the long term. That's all I have, Mayor.
Very good. You know, in fact, the vast majority of that new funding, a lot of that it will be spent into the 53 corridor, also the completion of the Murphy Park project. So, you know, that's very important to highlight as well. You know, and again, a lot of these funds, you know, for instance, again, the Taylor Road and the signalization at Romeoville High School, the vast majority of those funds are increased because they're grant funds, pass-through funds, but we do have to acknowledge that new money coming in.
Correct.
Into the budget. So while there may be money being expended, it's because money's coming in for the project as well, and it's important to highlight that.
That's a great point.
Because you have to account for the money coming in and out. So that just shows up as part of the overall increase. So sometimes it's important to remind people of that as well. And again, the bottom line being that the reality at the end of the day is there's no new taxes or fees. The average property tax for the municipal portion, and it's again important to remind people that the municipal portion, as we just said, as a percentage is going down, but it's a small portion of the overall bill. So your property tax bill may still go up, but you gotta look at what the other taxing bodies are, because we're only 13% of it. And that as a percentage of that total bill, we've been going down. And your real dollars, the real dollars you pay have been going down. And also you're gonna get a rebate. And all of the new projects have dedicated funding streams for them. So it's important to acknowledge that as well. Any other questions or comments? Trustee Paul Miner.
These are some pretty challenging
for every community. And I have to give a lot of credit to every one of the department heads and the staff in this village that prioritize things so our infrastructure does stay a priority, and they know where to be working next to make sure that we're on top of things. There were many, many years where that didn't happen because the money just wasn't there. But due to people like Kirk and Dan and Kelly, everybody in this room, you know, I just have to put the credit in their laps for being the responsible staff that we have here.
They do a great job. Any other questions or comments? A couple of things we didn't put in here, but probably worth highlighting as well, that came up in discussion. And remember, this process begins as far back as December as we do the mid-year review. Several months in making. There have been multiple meetings, public meetings that everyone could attend, budget meetings. So just so everybody realizes, there's been several months of work put in this before it becomes to this point. But one of the other things that in our final review last week that were probably worth highlighting is we expect our final surplus for this current year to be substantially higher than we originally estimated, maybe as much as over twice as high as we originally estimated. We had an original estimate of a surplus from this current year of $400,000, and that looks like that's going to be at least more than twice that when we close out this final year. So that's an additionally good point. So we're saving twice as much as we thought we were, over twice as much as we thought we were going to save this year. And the other good bit of good news is that our fund balance is substantially higher than it was even 4 or 5 years ago. It's now not quite, but approaching the $16 million mark, about $15.8 million. Where just 4 or 5 years ago it was probably 10 or less, right around there. And that's the amount of money that it's our fund balance, our operational account, and it's also kind of our reserves. So while other communities have had to spend down their reserves substantially to the point of almost having none, we've actually increased our reserves above and beyond so that we had the cash flow necessary to keep a good, healthy balance there. So important things that weren't on this immediate thing that also are worth highlighting. So anything else? Kirk, anything else you wanted to add to that?
No, I think you guys did an excellent job of hitting the main highlights from our budget presentation.
So in summary, we're building stuff and it's not costing you anymore. We're actually costing you less. So wonderful things, Kirk. As always, you do an amazing job. But I think we got you up here for another one.
Yes.
Resolution 1316148, resolution evidencing the intention of the Village of Romeoville, Will County, Illinois, to issue industrial revenue and single-family mortgage revenue bonds and related matters.
This is a housekeeping item that comes before the board every year. Under the state statutes, we're issued industrial revenue bond authority. Our limit this year, which is based on $95 per resident, is $3,791,640. So we're reserving the right for industrial revenue bond authority, which allows us to act as a conduit to issue tax-exempt bonds on behalf of businesses and for some other uses as well. If bonds do get issued, they are not a debt of the village. They are the debt of the underlying issuer. But it does provide a tax-exempt benefit to that issuer.
Okay.
And traditionally, if we have not had a project within the village to utilize these funds, we cede our authority onto the first-time assist homebuyers program, and the City of Aurora is the conduit issuer for that project.
Very good. Just to quick summarize what Mr. Opachowski just said, something that we do every year, it's not issuing any additional bonds that the village is issuing. It's reserving the right to be a conduit, basically a pass-through, for this unique economic development tool that also is often, and majority of the time, is used as our conduit for first-time homebuyer program, which is actually administered by Aurora for the vast majority of municipalities in the region, and that's just through a cooperative program that we do. So no additional cost to us. Questions or comments on that? Trustee McCovitz, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I just wanted to say that I've always struggled with grasping the concept for this, and even though I've been on the board for 4 years and we've done this every year, and it's always explained to me, and I always think I understand it, and then I don't. But I think it was Kirk spent a lot of time talking it over with me this year, that I understand it much better than I had in the past. And again, I'm much more familiar with general obligation bonds or revenue bonds, that the village actually does sell those or issue those bonds, and that is our debt. So that's where I was not understanding the difference of the industrial revenue bonds, where we're not actually issuing that, we're not creating that debt, we're just saying we want to participate in this program. So that if, for instance, there is an industrial project that comes to the village and says, we need some help, we can be the conduit, as what was said, and that allows that industry to basically borrow money at a tax-exempt status, so they see a savings.
Correct.
So they're the ones responsible for it, we're not.
Correct.
We're just the conduit. And as you're saying, if that project, if nobody comes forth with a project like that, then we're just gonna pass that over to the first-time home buyers project or program to be utilized for that.
Right.
So again, I've always had a difficult time understanding that we're not actually issuing the debt, but I appreciate you helping me understand that, and definitely went a long way for me to realize what we were doing with the program, so thank you.
No, it's an excellent point, because actually this is a really important issue, because it's something that's often debated at the federal level on potentially limiting the use of this, and it's one of the few economic development tools that is available to local jurisdictions, and it's very important, because you're right, it allows for what a project, especially if you're looking at a manufacturing industrial project that might not otherwise be able to happen, to get the financing that they need at a rate they can afford in order to make those capital investments possible, which then returns a lot of positives into the community and into the state and national economy. So and likewise, it does help foster, you know, more affordable rates for first-time home buyers that qualify and go through the program. So it's really a very good and very positive program. So very good. Any other questions, comments? Trustee Schvez?
Yes, thank you, Mayor. Yeah, I'm glad. I think this is a great thing that we're offering to potential people, business people in our area. Kirk, I think we talked, what was the last company or industry that utilized this here in Romeoville?
CGI.
Yeah. You know, and this just is an example of the opportunities that we can offer marketing our municipality to industries. CGI took advantage of this. It's a big corporation, big company, big industry. So this is just another avenue, and, you know, this is a tool for us to market Romeoville, to bring industry here. This is key, it's critical. But it doesn't cost us as residents any money. It's a great thing. Thank you, Mayor.
Very good. Thank you very much. Any other questions or comments? Hearing none, we're going to move on. We're now going to move on to Resolution 131644, a resolution approving a concession stand license agreement between Premier Concessions, Inc. and the Village of Romeoville. Kelly?
Thank you, Mayor. Attaches a resolution that authorizes a license agreement to operate the concession stands at Volunteer Park and Village Park from May 1st to November 15th. We've done this in the past. We did do our RFPs, and Jim, again, came in. He is with the Premier Concessions to run our concession stands. We were happy with him last year, and we will be getting a 7% overall of the revenues. We did ask all our sport organizations if they would like to run our concession stands, and they did not want to.
It's a big job.
It's a big job.
It is.
Any questions or comments? Nope. Very good. We'll move on. Resolution 131645, resolution for the use of MFT funds to fund the village's portion of the Taylor Road East project cost. John Zabrocki.
Thank you, Mayor and Board. If you would, I'd actually...
Resolution 131646, resolution to use of the MFT funds for the village portion of Taylor Road West project cost. John Zabrocki, please.
Thank you, sir. And your guys' discussion of the budget, you alluded to both these projects. They're both grant projects. Like any grant, you know that there's a local match. The local match for this is going to be paid for out of our MFT, motor fuel tax, the state money that we get. And what's before you tonight are just the resolutions, paperwork that we have to submit with the Illinois Department of Transportation, setting those funds aside.
Very good.
Straightforward stuff.
It really is an excellent opportunity. We originally received the first portion of the grant, and then we're able to secure a second leg of it, will allow the village to resurface and redo Taylor Road all the way from 53 to really to I-55.
All right.
So it's an excellent project, a major roadway, and it's an 80% federal funded grant. And so, and then use of our state motor fuel taxes to cover the remaining portion. But a great way to make an investment and get a very important roadway that is a huge economic engine for this community, and then also covers a large portion of our residential population as well. So questions and comments? Trustee Pallmeyer, please.
Do we have any idea what the exact schedule is going to be? I know it's posted already that it's going to be, some say closed, some say expect delays. I get the questions almost hourly. Just exactly, do we have any idea? Are they going to close half at a time? How are we going to go about this?
Sure. The actual construction will start on Monday the 22nd, so it's coming up. And this is for the section that's between Illinois 53 and Weber Road. It's the Taylor Road East portion of the project. Mm-hmm. It's the portion that's actually on the screen behind you guys.
Right.
There are going to be some detours. There are going to be some delays, of course. The part that's going to be closed is the piece that's right. It's the part that frontage, it's on the screen behind you. It's basically where it says West Taylor Road.
Mm-hmm.
Way on the west end of that, it's kind of the piece that frontages the Ward Farm that's there.
Mm-hmm.
What we're doing is we're actually adding concrete at some of the intersections. Some of you are familiar with right near where the high school is, where we get that rutting in the asphalt.
Yeah.
These intersections that see a lot of truck traffic now are getting redone with concrete. So that's a section there that we are closing. It's going to be one way. You'll come out and you'll head back to the east and then down South Creek and back to Weber that way. And we're also doing that at the intersection of South Creek and Taylor, and then ultimately down at 53 and Taylor as well. To answer your question, 2 to 3 months is the schedule that we have. Of course, days like today, it'll get longer than that. Hopefully we don't have many of these. So the detours itself, where we're gonna close those, 2 to 3 weeks, again, a function of weather, overall 2 to 3 months.
Very good. Thank you.
And Trustee Pallmeyer, we were putting it on the webpage. We're trying to do a news release, get out on the e-news to let residents know of the detour. There'll be an actual map of the detour, and just to get some education out there to the residents.
Good. Thank you.
Which is an excellent point. If you use these routes and you're not already signed up for a newsletter or check our webpage, you might want to do that right away so you can get the latest. Mm-hmm. And Joe, where do they sign up for that?
Right on our webpage.
And what's that? Romeoville.org.
Romeoville.org, that's correct.
You're my e-newsletter expert. So if you haven't already done so, you might want to avail yourself of that great service, and so that you've got that information and get the updates as quickly as possible. So any other questions or comments? Trustee Richards, please.
Just a quick one more to keeping residents informed, keeping in mind that we also have text service available now. So even if you're not an internet person, you're not on a computer all day, you can get those updates text to you right through to your phone. And again, you are going to have to go to the website to sign up for that. But if you go to romeoville.org, it's something that maybe is a lot simpler for people to see throughout the day as things change.
Excellent point. Any other questions or comments?
I have one comment. You know, I was glad Mr. Brocky brought up, I'm glad they're taking initiative now to put down the concrete base. Mm-hmm. Because of the traffic that we have out there. That's a great idea. I totally forgot about that, and I'm glad you brought that up. That's a key major improvement to this road, you know, putting the concrete bases in there. Thank you.
Because not only is it, you know, resurfacing, but it's actually a pretty substantial improvement for a longer haul.
Absolutely.
So, very good. Any other questions or comments? Hearing none, we'll move on then. John, we got the next one, Resolution 131647, Resolution authorizing payment to Steve Speed's Construction for storm sewer installation at the intersection of Hudson and Hillcrest.
Thank you, Mayor and Board. You kind of go in the way back machine a little bit. If you remember, we've worked with the developer of Misty Ridge a number of times to resolve various items out there. Most recently was some pavement. We had an opportunity last fall, as they were finalizing some of their pavement issues, to improve, and you'll see it behind you there, the intersection at Hudson, and basically it's Hudson and Hillcrest. That was part of the old subdivisions, never any storm sewer. Water basically came down from Veterans Parkway and all the way down to Normantown. And now with the construction of Misty Ridge, there's storm sewer there, and we were again, a small window there to add some inlets into that intersection and get rid of some of that storm water, pick it up before it came down to Normantown. We went with Steven Spies Construction. They're a contractor you've heard the name of numerous times. We have an open PO with them every year, year in and year out. At the end of the day, this came in at $28,000 and change. Since it's greater than $20,000, as we've done in the past, it exceeded the amount that we wanted to at least bring it back to the board. This work is done. The improvements work great. But again, given the dollar amounts involved, we need to bring it back to the board.
No, it's a great opportunity to piggyback off that project and create a very important improvement to that area and take the opportunity. Any questions or comments?
Nope. I think it's great.
Good job. Hearing none, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin. Second by Trustee Richards. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
And Trustee McClellan.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. We'll go right into the Village of Romeoville's regular meeting this Wednesday, April 17th at 6:47 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Here.
Trustee Chavez.
Here.
Trustee Clancy. Trustee Richards.
Here.
Trustee McClevitz.
Here.
Trustee Griffin.
Here.
Mayor Noak.
Here.
We have a quorum.
Trustee Pallmeyer, will you lead us in the pledge?
Yes, thank you. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Next, we have petitions from the public. As a reminder, we have 3 minutes. Please state your name and address. Petitions from the public.
Good evening, Thomas Soliga, 340 Dartmoor. Good evening, board. As Trustee Chavez alluded on what Mr. Zabracki said about the Taylor improvements, it's a great thing that it's being done. It was also said about the concrete going at the 53 and Taylor. It's gonna be helpful. However, as it was said before, it's the really truck that caused the damage, especially I've noticed because I take this route every day. Last summer, with the heat that we had, lack of rain, those trucks were sitting on the red light, and the vibrations from the engine obviously caused the damage to the road. I think it was mentioned our portion would be about 20%, and then 80% is the grants. I think, is it possible to maybe recoup some of that damage down to the road? I don't know, maybe there's a possibility for something like that. But it's not very hard to point fingers at where it might have been done. Additionally, a lot of those trucks that take down the route, also 53, are going with open beds. So when they transporting gravel or other material, when they bump, this thing is just spilling all over the street. I don't think we need a tragedy to happen before enforcement is done, but I think there must be some kind of law making sure that they cover the truck beds. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other petitions from the public this evening? Any other petitions from the public?
Hi, I'm Chris Brash, 42 Abbeywood.
I'm Terry Hinchy from 418 Healy.
We're here on behalf of the Harvest Saturday Food Drive Committee. And we'd like to take this opportunity to thank not only the mayor, the Board of Trustees, and all the village staff, and the citizens of Romeoville for your past support, but again, for future food raising, whatever.
We got you.
This year, Harvest Saturday is again the Saturday before Thanksgiving. That's November 23rd, so you can go ahead and put that on your calendars. And this coming Monday, April 22nd, we will be having a fundraiser at Culver's on Weber Road, and it's an all-day fundraiser. There will be participants from the committee there from 4 to 8 p.m., but all day long, if there's some flyers that we've got to pass out, and you can take those with you, and then a portion of the proceeds from the sales from the day will actually be donated back to Harvest Saturday, which provides food to a number of pantries, the
We Care,
St. Shepherd. Andrew's, Good Shepherd, DuPage Township, lots. So, let's see, the fundraiser, and then we just like to again thank you for all your support, and just to remind you that our goal, and I'm sure everyone's goal, especially with all the things that are going on in America today, is to let no man, woman, or child go hungry. Thank you so much.
Very good. Thank you both. Any other petitions from the public this evening? Any other petitions from the public? Great. Any other petitions from public? All right, hearing none, we'll move on. Motion for consent agenda?
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Second. Griffin. Second by Trustee Pallmeyer. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee McClellan.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Within that consent agenda, we have approval of minutes from April 3rd, 2013 workshop meeting, approval of minutes April 3rd, 2013 regular meeting, approval of minutes April 11th, 2013 special meeting, and approval of bill schedule A, approval of bill schedule B, and approval of bill schedule C. Do we have a motion?
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Richards, second by Trustee Pallmeyer. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Great. We will move into Mayor's Report. First thing we will do is we will open the public hearing for the 2013-2014 budget. Do I have a motion to open a public hearing?
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin.
Second.
Second by Trustee Richards. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Is there anybody to hear speak with the public hearing for the budget? Anyone to speak with the public hearing for the budget? Anyone to speak at the public hearing for the budget? Hearing none, got to get a motion to close the public hearing for the budget.
So moved.
I got a motion by Trustee Richards.
Second.
Second by Trustee Griffin, just because you're alive. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Great. Now my comments. Harvest Saturday, can't say enough good stuff about it. It's a wonderful group. Let me know what you raise. I think I'll add a lot to it. You guys do a wonderful job. Love you to death. And we'll be there for you on collection day again. So maybe I'll get the little guy out too. Great group. Just one of those wonderful experiences. I do want to say to the comment regarding the truck traffic, obviously we do keep an eye on the trucks. If anybody ever notices a truck with not covering in violation of the state law, please call the police department. There are regulations that the state has put in place. If they're on our roads or somebody else's roads, just call us. We'll figure out who has to do the enforcement, but we never want to see a truck that is not properly covering what they need to cover.
We're more happy to take the revenue on the ticket.
You know, the county takes most of that, but. and just as a important reminder, that those trucks and those industrial facilities do finance a large portion of everything that the village does, and the vast chunk of all those motor fuel taxes are actually paid for by those trucks. Mm-hmm. Just as a reminder. But on to other things. I want to, first of all, congratulate everyone that won in the election. I also want to recognize everyone that ran, because it's not always easy, trust me, to put your name on a ballot. And it says a lot that people even take the opportunity to run and participate. I also want to thank everybody who came out and voted. A large number in our community, in fact, a largest number ever for a community election in Romeoville, for a consolidated election. So, lots of people put a lot of time and effort, and they should all be recognized for their efforts. And it is part of our process in this country and an important part of our process. So thank you to everybody that was involved. And we'll talk more about that at swearing in. Thank everybody. And before I go off, I also want to recognize the people that have some colleagues that will be leaving office. Especially Mayor Murphy from Woodridge, who's one of the longest serving, if not the longest serving mayor in the state of Illinois. And I do want to just publicly acknowledge that he will be leaving. And then also Mayor Trivedi from Lockport will also be leaving office and retiring. Both gentlemen that I've had the pleasure of working with, their next door neighbors. Everybody else is still around, so I do want to take a quick moment and just recognize both of them. They've been great colleagues and great to work with them. So also want to thank everybody who came out to the Veterans Commission Pancake Breakfast. Veteran Commission did a great job, and staff did a great job again. My son enjoyed his pancakes quite well, and especially the sausages. but I think everybody had a good time. A lot of people came out. It was a good event. So thank you for all that supported that effort. If it stops raining, maybe, get to throw out one of the first pitches tomorrow at the Will County Sheriff's Police Spring Classic. We'll see. Good luck with that one. Gonna let me know about that, right, folks? Also, we will have our Relay for Life kickoff event that will be held tomorrow at 7 at the Rec Center. The Hero Helps Community Forum will be at Lewis University on April 19th. Important event talking about some of the drug issues within our county. And something that our police department has worked with in the past in the state's attorney's office. They got some great speakers coming out. It's the second time or third time now that we've had it at Lewis, second time. And we had a great partnership with the state's attorney's office, sheriff's office, and everyone else that's also involved, the county executive's office. So it really is a regional issue, and it's great to have those partnerships with them. So they do an excellent job on this program. Also, Springtide Craft Show coming up Saturday at the Rec Center, 9 to 3. Always a good time. We usually pick up a couple kids' books at that. Also, Rasmussen College School of Nursing will be holding their ribbon cutting April 24th at 11 o'clock. Another group doing fantastic in our community. There will be a community work day on April 27th at Isle of Kesh Museum, hosted by the Forest Preserve and Julian Comcast. It sounds like a great event to go out there, which is, and for those who have never been to the Isle of Kesh Museum in Romeoville, it's just an amazing asset to have in our own backyard. I do encourage you to go out there and visit it. Also, St. Andrews will be holding their gala on April 27th at the Bolingbrook Golf Club. I'm sure many of us will be attending that as well. And I'm sure there's about a dozen other things, but I'm sure the board will mention those. So got to let everybody else talk about some stuff too. So I am done and just glad to be here, and hopefully everybody survives all this rain that we've been having. So next, clerk's report, please.
Thank you, Mayor Noak. To begin, the Senior Service Commission met on Tuesday, April 9th, and discussed the next seminar, which will be held on May 7th from 6 to 8 p.m. at the Recreation Center. The next seminar will involve universal design, aging in place, what caregivers, family members, people with disabilities, or homeowners can do to make their homes accessible and functional for wheelchairs and walkers. A meal will be provided for those in attendance. If you have not reserved a spot already, please contact the Romeoville Recreation Department today. The next meeting will be held on Tuesday, May 14th at 9:30 a.m. here at Village Hall. The Community Service Council met Monday, April 15th at the Bolingbrook Village Hall. The next meeting will be May 21st at their new location in Bolingbrook. I forgot to write the address down. Kirk, do you know the new address of the Community Service Council?
I believe it's 440 Quadrangle. I'm not 100% sure. I know it's in Quadrangle. I'm not sure of the numbers.
Thank you. I would also like to thank the voters for their support at the April 9th election, and also congratulations to Mayor Noak, Trustee Clancy, Trustee Chavez, and Trustee Richards on their reelection. And finally, congratulations to the four fire lieutenants and the new firefighter paramedic. That's it for me.
Very good. I'm kind of glad that they got you with your 100%. Also, citizens, committees, commissions, and liaison reports. Trustee McCubbins, Youth Outreach, Green Team, and Rima.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. As far as the Green Team is concerned, I just wanted to remind everyone that we do have an electronic recycling center. It's located at 195 Butler Road. The hours are Wednesday evenings, 6 to 8 p.m., and Saturdays to from 11 o'clock to 3 o'clock. So if you have any electronics that you're looking to get rid of, make sure to take them out to 195 Butler Road. Youth Outreach Committee, the next meeting for Youth Outreach Commission is going to take place Monday, June 3rd at 6 o'clock p.m. at the Recreation Department. And with REMA, they've been very busy, as usual, assisting with various events. They have a very ambitious upcoming schedule for April and May. They're definitely a group of volunteers that stays busy. They are welcoming a new addition, Peter O'Connor, and saying goodbye to a longtime member who's going on a leave of absence. That's Jeff Dammit. REMA Director Mike Luttrell is busy preparing safety manuals for each of the village departments, and he has updated a training schedule. So fantastic work by Mike Luttrell. And since in the absence of Trustee Clancy, I'm gonna go ahead and give recreation.
Sounds like a plan.
All right. If you're into day camps, register today for the Fun in the Sun Day Camp. The Recreation Department puts on a fantastic day camp program, and from what I understand, last year was record numbers, and everybody had a ton of fun at the day camps. So you wanna make sure to try and register for that. There is a discount if you register before June 1st. And the camp hours are from 9 o'clock till 4 o'clock. And again, it just, you can't beat it. It's a great program and the kids have a ton of fun at it. The 9th annual Springtide Craft Show will be held Saturday, April 20th. So that's right around the corner. At the Recreation Center from 9 to 3. Again, it's a fantastic program. A lot of people showing their various crafts. So you definitely want to come out to that. Come early, have breakfast at the Knights of Columbus Pancake Breakfast, bake sale by the Golden Age Club, and concessions are also available. So it's an all-around fun event. And lastly, the Lockport Township Park District is offering a trip to Oklahoma at the Lyric Opera House. That's going to be Wednesday, May 15th, and you can contact the Lockport Township Park District to find out more information about that. And that's all I have.
Very good. Thank you very much. And just for the folks at home, Trustee Clancy, I think this is the first time I've ever seen him actually take time off and take a vacation. I think we can excuse him that he gets to visit his son. So, but just to let everybody know that he's all right, and he's just getting to visit family a little bit. That's okay. First time in 4 years I've seen that. Trustee Richards, Planning and Zoning, Zoning Board of Appeals, and Downtown Redevelopment.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Downtown Redevelopment, no report tonight. Next meeting will be in June. As far as Planning and Zoning, next Planning and Zoning meeting is scheduled for April 23rd, 7 p.m. We meet right here in the boardroom. And that agenda is a public hearing for the Village of Romeoville zoning map as well as an approval for the Sam's Club easement. That's all I have.
Very good. They are moving on that Sam's Club. They Anybody are. Hasn't been out there and see it in the gas station, they're putting the tanks in today. If you've never seen the tanks go in, that's kind of interesting to see, too.
It's amazing how quickly they're moving on that. And to let everybody know, the plan is to have that open this year. I know it may seem hard to believe that it's April and you just saw walls go up. But, yeah, they're in a hurry to open up, and they will get it done. It's amazing how quickly they put those buildings together.
Mm-hmm. Things are moving along over at Misswood, too. But as John pointed out, it all really depends on that lovely rain we all hear right now. Trustee Griffin, Veterans Commission and RPTV.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. Yeah, and if they dug those holes today, you're going to have three big swimming pools in the parking lot.
I'm confident that that's what they ended up with.
I don't have anything on RPTV. But the Veterans Commission recently, as you heard, hosted a pancake breakfast. And there were over 120 people that showed up and a lot of volunteers that did work. And they raised $386 to go to the Veterans Scholarship Fund. The Veterans Commission also raised $428 outside of Tasty Waffle. And also, we don't have the numbers yet from Culver's, but as Harvest Saturday is doing, Ron Darwimple from Culver's is a terrific local business that helps all kinds of worthy organizations in their fundraising, and he is to be commended for it. And other veteran stuff, we've got over $1,000 now in the scholarship fund, so that's going to be terrific when it comes time to award those in May. We've got a voicemail line for if any veterans have any questions or anything about the Veterans Commission, just call into Village Hall, leave a message, we'll get back to you with the answers that you need. And our next meeting is going to be July the 16th at 4:00 in the Rec Center. And that's all I've got.
Thank you. Trustee Pallminer, Finance and Humane Society.
Thank you. In lieu of our finance meeting last week, we held our budget workshop, so we will not have another finance meeting until next month. The Humane Society, I think I'll just go over their wish list, which is pretty extensive but pretty simple. Number one is money. They can always use money to take care of the animals that people are fostering presently. Once again, I'd like to remind people some of the animals that they have taken in have not yet found foster homes and are in a situation where they're being well taken care of, but they need human contact. So if you do want to open your heart and your home to a needy animal, please contact them. You can go right to Romeoville.org and follow all the prompts to get right to their website. But they need things like money, cat litter, dog food, puppy food, treats, anything that you can bring to those people. They need disinfectants, sanitizer, old blankets and towels. Just things like that will help comfort an animal in need. Leashes, collars, bowls. They're not fussy about anything that you want to contribute to them because they'll make use of everything. And that's all I have.
Very good. Trustee Chavez, Fire and Police and EDC.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. DEC, no update. EDC will be tomorrow, the 18th, at Key Foods, 8 a.m. And no update on Police and Fire. I believe you witnessed today how busy they've been. Just glad to see them finally get all that accomplished. It was a long process, and I give them a lot of credit. You know, it was a learning process for both sides, all three sides, I guess it's fair to say, the municipality, the union, and the commission. So I just want to say their next meeting is May 14th on Tuesday. That's all I have, Mayor.
Very good. Village Manager's Report.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. Two quick things. First of all, congratulations to the Mayor, Trustee Clancy, Richards, and Chavez on their reelection. We look forward to obviously working with you and keeping this great team together. It's been a very, very good 4 years, and we look forward to the next several years. Second, I have a statement I need to read as part of the EPA grant that we have. It has to be on public record, so I'm just going to go ahead and read this statement. It's regarding Spartan Square and the cleanup, the EPA cleanup at Spartan Square. The United States Environmental Protection Agency has awarded the Village of Romeoville $200,000 in brownfield cleanup grant funds for remediation of hazardous substances at the Spartan Square Shopping Center redevelopment site. These funds will be used to conduct remediation of contaminated soil containing elevated levels of dry cleaning solvents, monitor air during remediation, reporting of remediation activities, participate in the Illinois EPA Voluntary Site Remediation Program, and conduct community outreach activities. The Village of Romeoville has an administrative record on site documents available for public review and is on file at the Village Hall and the Clerk's Office. In addition, the information is available on the Village of Romeoville's website at www.romeoville.org. So just a matter of house cleaning there. And that's all I have.
Thank you very much, and I'm sure we all thank you for your comments. And as I said, we'll probably elaborate on our thank yous to everybody, including the public at the swearing in, which we'll have. We are scheduled tentatively for May 1st.
So. That's correct.
New business. First one we have is Ordinance 131043, an ordinance adopting the annual operating budget for the fiscal year 2013-2014 for the Village of Romeoville, Will County, Illinois.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Pallmeyer.
Second.
Second by Trustee Richards. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Next, we have Resolution 131644, resolution approving a concession stand license agreement between Premier Concessions, Inc. and the Village of Romeoville.
So moved.
Motion approved by Trustee Richards.
Second.
Second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Next, we have Resolution 131645, a resolution for the use of MFT funds for the to fund the village's portion of Taylor Road East project costs.
So moved.
Second.
Second.
Motion by Trustee Chavez. Second by Trustee Pallmeyer. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Next, we have Resolution 131646, resolution for the use of the MFT funds to fund the village's portion of the Taylor Road West project costs. Do we have a motion?
So moved.
Motion second. By Trustee Griffin. Second by Trustee McClevitz. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Next, we have Resolution 131647, a resolution authorizing to payment to Steve Spies Construction for storm sewer installation at the intersection of Hudson and Hillcrest.
So moved.
Motion second. By Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Pallmeyer. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Next, we have Resolution 131648, resolution evidencing into the intention the Village of Romeoville, Will County, Illinois, to issue industrial revenue and single-family mortgage revenue bonds and related matters.
So moved.
Second. Motion by Trustee Richards, second by Trustee McClevitz. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Board comments. Trustee Chavez, please.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. I'd like to start off by congratulating our four fire lieutenants. I think the municipality has taken another step forward in our growth. In our growth in our fire department, as we are growing as a community ourselves, this is just another step. And then obviously bringing in a new firefighter, paramedic. Yes, you're correct, Chief. He looks very young. Looks like we'll get a lot of life out of him, which is good.
Maybe a little increased population, too.
Increased population as well, absolutely. So that's real good to see that we're able to expand our fire department, and we'll continue, obviously, to expand our police department. And I just want to say happy birthday to Anna, 100 years. She's a very lucky lady, and she looks in very good health for her age. So it was real nice to see. Congratulations to everybody who won their elections. I'd like to point out that we have two other Romeoville residents, that one, Ken Burgess, who's on the DuPage Township trustee, lives in Romeoville, so we have representation over there now. And then, of course, Victor Zett, he's on our library board. Now that makes our second Romeoville resident representation in another office. But I think I missed somebody here, but that's fine. Patty. Oh, and Patty. Patty, I'm sorry, Patty. Doc's daughter. Congratulations, Patty, to the DuPage Township also. Thank you. I was just reviewing all my notes.
You give them back later.
A thousand apologies.
Oh, you definitely can give them back later.
Sorry, Patty. My luck, she was here. But, you know, I just wanted to, a lot of hard work. One thing I love about the elections is the door-to-door knocking. That's where you really get a good taste, a good sense of where the residents are in the municipality. And just kind of like what's going on tonight, we went ahead and approved the monies for the sewer over there on Hudson. And, you know, and the people were real happy that we put a four-way stop sign there. You know, that was huge for that neck of the neighborhood. And it's just, it's really exciting. I really enjoy that part of it, but it is a lot of hard work. Everybody who ran knows it's a lot of hard work, and it was nice to decompress after the election. That's all I have, Mayor. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And I'm glad you did point out a few of the other residents that ran, and I do want to extend an invitation for them and to be recognized at our swearing in on May 1st as well. We'll take some time and recognize them along with it. It is nice to recognize those that are serving from our community. And
absolutely.
We've seen a lot of people step over up the last few years, and it's really nice to see that. Yeah. So, Trustee Pallminer, please.
Thank you. I would just, first of all, like to remind everyone about the Relay for Life, as the mayor alluded to earlier. The kickoff celebration is tomorrow. If you have not previously been involved in this, please step forward and see what a memorable experience it is. Supporting friends, family, there's not one of us that haven't been touched by this horrible disease. It's very important we support this organization so they continue to do the research to help obliterate this disease. Once again, the Relay for Life of Romeoville kickoff celebration will be at the Recreation Center tomorrow night at 7 p.m. 900 West Romeo Road. Sign up for a team. There's just a lot of things you can do. You can also go to the relayforlife.org Romeoville website and sign up there. Come up with a team or join one of the teams that are already active. It's just a worthwhile thing, and you will never be sorry that you were involved in it. I'd also like to congratulate all those that were elected, re-elected yesterday, or last week, sorry about that. Now, it just seems like yesterday, doesn't it?
Tell me.
To some people, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a lot of hard work, and it's a lot of dedication that these people, whether they won or they lost, put into that effort of getting elected. Patty and Ken and Victor, I won't forget any of you.
Dig, dig, dig.
My fellow board members, it's good to be seated with the same folks once again. I know everybody put a lot of hard work into it. Whether you won or lost, it's important that you cared enough about your residents to put your heart out there, and I do appreciate it. Congratulations to our new lieutenants. Welcome to our new firefighter paramedic. Anna Bozinski, just another one of the treasures that Romeoville has to offer, 100 years old. That's just amazing. And that's all I have.
Very good. Trustee Griffin, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I would like to add my congratulations and acknowledgement of everybody who had won in the most recent election. And thank all the voters for coming out. It was a beautiful day, and doing your civic duty, and it was greatly appreciated, I'm sure, by everyone. As somebody who has actually had a fire at their home, I know how important the fire department can be, and I want to congratulate them. And they're the kind of people that you never want to meet them, you know, professionally, but you want to have them available when you do need them. So I want to congratulate all of them and the paramedics as well, because when you get to be my age, the paramedics are the ones that you're going to meet the most, I think. Congratulate Anna on her 100th birthday. And the Harvest Saturday folks, good luck to you. It's a great community. And I encourage anybody in the audience who has never worked to that, come out and volunteer. It's something to behold, to see that mass of humanity and that mass of canned goods crunching your fingers as they come through the line. Come out and give them a hand. It's a wonderful cause, and you'll feel real good about it. And that's all I've got.
Very good. Trustee Richards, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I want to thank everyone, of course, that did run for office, regardless of what side of that vote you were on. As everyone has said, and as everyone up here knows, it's quite a task to take on. It's a lot of work. Obviously, there are many people out there that care about the community and try to get involved in many different ways. It takes everyone to make it successful. I am so glad that we don't have to look at signs anymore, even though a lot of them were ours. But you know what? It's so nice to see the town look like Romeoville again. So I am glad that they are all gone. I want to, of course, thank congratulate our fire lieutenants and our new firefighter paramedic. It's interesting to watch these guys. Four of them up here getting sworn in as lieutenants tonight. And we've got a new one getting sworn in, and in comes Anna at 100 years old. And they, regardless of what was going on at the time, immediately just started to walk out of the room, mm-hmm. because that's what they do. They went to help her. They grabbed the chair, they went and got her, they brought her in. It wasn't about them, even though this was partially their night. And that's how firefighters and policemen are. That's how they serve, and we are proud to have such quality men and women here in Romeoville. So I want to congratulate all of them. And of course, to live to be 100 years old, you know, that's an amazing feat. I'm going to give Nancy Hackett, who's sitting out in the crowd, a little plug right now, because no, she's not 100 years old. I wasn't trying to talk about her age. What I wanted to talk about.
You guys don't even. You're glad you're in front of that term.
Good thing it's after the election. What I wanted to bring up was the fact that this is an amazing woman who's been in town a number of years and has learned the history of Romeoville through the Historical Society, and has a book on Romeoville coming out very soon. In fact, Trustee Clancy has spent many, many hours with her going through pictures and trying to put together a history of the community we live in. I was trying to tie it into Anna being here for 100 years. Sorry about that, Nancy. but you know what? She deserves a lot of credit for the time she puts in through our Historical Society and through everything she did. By the way, also a member of the White Oak Library Board. So a woman who serves the community very well. I want to recognize her for that hard work she puts in. Couple of the quick ones. The Veterans Commission Pancake Breakfast was very good. Enjoyed it. Hopefully everyone comes out and supports the Knights of Columbus. As Trustee McLevitz mentioned before the craft show, Knights of Columbus will be doing a pancake breakfast at the Rec Center this Saturday. 8 to 11, I think, are their hours for breakfast. The craft show is 9 to 3. You know, again, they like to raise money and give it away, like a lot of other groups do in town. Harvest Saturday, we've got all summer to talk about that, but please come out and support their fundraiser April 22nd. What I really want to mention is something else that was said before, is that Ron from Culver's is just an amazing guy, mm-hmm. for a local businessman. If you go in there and say, I need to raise money, he just says, okay, let's set a date. He helps every group that comes his way. He does whatever he can for people. So if you can go out and support Culver's in any way, even beyond Monday with even beyond the 22nd with Harvest Saturday, don't forget some of these local business people that get behind all these groups and make these fundraisers possible. And you know what? Oh, one last note. Had a little surprise at RC Hill, and I want to give this family a little bit of a shout out. Nicholas Alexander is a Marine returned from boot camp and had attended RC Hill. And the third grade class there had been writing him letters. So he popped in his dress blues to say hi and surprise them all. And very, very good young man, nice young man. The grandson of Charlie and Blanche Smith, longtime residents. Nick's dad was a Marine, long history of military service. Charlie and Blanche have a son that served as well. So, you know, just another good family in town. It was nice for Nick to come out and surprise those kids like that, and they got a little lesson in real life history from them right there. And hopefully they stay in touch with him as he gets deployed wherever the Marines take him. But I just wanted to give that family a little bit of recognition as well. That's all I have.
Very good. You know, you point out a great thing about the history when you're talking about someone like Anna's been here for 100 years. I was just thinking about this. And I'm going to have to go to the Historical Society and look at some of the pictures, because I'm going to say that you think about this in this terms. When Anna was born, there were probably maybe 3-5 buildings on this side of the river in Romeoville. Romeoville was really just that east side of the river when she was born.
The true east side.
So if you want to talk about a true east sider, yeah, that's Anna. Anna's the only one who can say she's a real east sider. That's something to keep in perspective. That's how long she's been in this community, and that is really an amazing thing. So she's living history. Trustee McClevitz, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I would also like to say congratulations to all of our promoted fire personnel. Exciting times at the fire department to finally get to this point, so congratulations on that. And welcome our newest firefighter paramedic. And obviously I can't not say happy 100th birthday to Anna. You know, everybody has said it, but I do want to say it too. Boy, wouldn't we all like to live to be 100 years old. How fantastic was that? So happy birthday to Anna. A couple notes, spring cleanup week, May 13th through the 17th. Is a time to get rid of some of your larger garbage. The garbage pickup will be on your regular day with unlimited pickup of large items. No tires, hazardous waste, or electronics, but it's time to start cleaning things up and get it out there. Again, May 13th through 17th, and garbage pickup is on your regular day. I wanted to say kudos to the police officers. We're talking about the fire district, but also kudos to our police officers. They managed a situation on Rogers Road recently and did such a fantastic job that one of the neighbors actually sent a complimentary letter who praised the actions of the police officers. So I did want to mention that, and thank you to the professionalism of our police officers. Another opportunity to start cleaning out your homes. You can participate in the community garage sale, and that's scheduled for May 11th. So May is the time to clean. You get rid of your garbage, you get to go to the garage sale, or participate, I mean, in the community garage sale. If you wanna be on the list of all the homes that participate in the garage sale, make sure to get your information to the Recreation Department by April 26th, and they will include you on the publication that lists all of the homes that participate in the community garage sale. And again, May 11th is the day for the garage sale. April 26th is when you need to get your information to the Recreation Department. May 18th, right around the corner, that's the Truck and 5K race, so there's still time to get in shape for that. The race is also accompanied by a Touch a Truck event for the children, so it's gonna be a fantastic event for everybody, fun for all. And again, I just wanna say kudos to everybody who ran for public office. It's as was said already, it's definitely not an easy task to put your name out there and run for public office. To everyone who took on the challenge, great job. For those who won, congratulations. For those who didn't, thank you for your desire of wanting to represent and serve the residents of Romeoville. We certainly appreciate that dedication. And I want to end my comments the way the mayor started his the evening, and just send my condolences to all the victims of the Boston Marathon tragedy. That's all I have.
Very good. We're gonna have some fire trucks at that truck and race and everything that it is. Good, because, you know, truck is a fairly new word to Sebastian, but he is all about truck right now. Very excited. Fire truck. He knows fire truck. He's learned it, like in the last week. So definitely come out. Glad you mentioned that. So, and like you said, please remember those who in these tough times that lost their lives in a tragedy, and definitely those who survived and were touched by it. And it reminds us all that every day we just watch out for each other and appreciate the time that we have. As we've seen, Anna got to appreciate 100 years of it. So. With that, we're going to entertain a motion for an executive session.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Richards. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz?
Aye.
This motion carried.
There won't be any announcements, so thank you and good evening.